Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So this is literally 4 pages long of A4, so go grab yourself a cup of tea and get comfy. So I thought we'd have a little chat about Bess's situation. As you may have noticed, I have only been publishing either videos that I have filmed a couple of weeks ago, or the ones that were filmed recently would have been hacking ones. And this is because hacking is all I can do with Bess at the moment. So, as some of my friends know, we bought Bess 3 years ago and she was not able to canter correctly on the right rein and would always strike off on the wrong leg. My mum thought that she could just school her out of it, but we never actually got around to doing that. We had come close to solving the issue so many times in the first year of owning her that we always ended up going backwards. So, as you know, this summer has been a summer full of fun, friends, competitions and pony club despite COVID-19. And to be honest with you, it has been the best summer of my life. I've enjoyed every second of it. At the end of Pony Club Camp, I did my first ever one day event. I knew that eventing was what I wanted to do, even before I did it. I enjoy all three disciplines and I can see me joining BE in the future and competing my next horse in different BE levels. My ultimate goal would be to go to badminton grassroots. And I just thought I'd point out that I will not be joining BE on Bess. She is not the right build and is very small, although I do think she'd love it. So if she's 100% better, healed in 2 years down the road, they bring out B70 and I don't grow out of her, then yeah, sure, but I really don't see that happening. So anyway, back to the subject. I would love to carry on doing Pony Club and lots of PC one day events, and I even have my mind on doing a tetrathlon or two in the future with Bess. So, because of this, we decided to send her away for 2 weeks of schooling livery with my instructor. We delivered her on the 8th of November 2020. Bess was a little bit, complicated to ride, because there were so many new things I had to do on her compared to normal. And she was getting the right leg frequently, and we were super pleased with her progress. While she was there, she was also taught to work more uphill, as she has quite a downwards build. We raised her head quite high so the bum wouldn't come up for a buck and did various things to improve her way of going in general. If all went to plan, we would have made a machine of a pony within a few weeks. But no, something always has to go wrong with horses. And then my instructor asked me if I wanted to get on her horse. This was because I needed to feel what it was like to be on the right leg and the correct leg when I was in the canter, rather than having to look down every time I do the transition. It's quite funny because I'm on this gorgeous, gorgeous pony, and then my pony is trying to chop the rider off. So I was just grinning the entire time, and I was super, super pleased with her.
Do it on my own, but I'm never alone now. So your shoulders go back and your hips go forward. That's it, good. Do 3 or 4 of those while you've got the opportunity. You got there yet?
No, I'm waiting, I can't.
So the first time I properly schooled her was when I had a lesson with my instructor and we took the pony back home. Everything was going so well until I experienced a buck.
Yes, that's it, and uphill as well. Bend out and uphill the shoulders. Sit on that seesaw, get the bottom of the seesaw down. Sit on her bottom and push it downwards. Good. Yeah, and keep it up, keep it up, keep it up, and count. Yes! And then, whoa. Oh, not a bucking, a walking pattern.
Mm.
Right, sit. Can you feel that's quite hard work for her?
Yeah.
Good, there. Keep it up, no, no. Yes, yes. Keep lean out and back. So you're leaning over her left hind leg. Put your shoulders over her left hind leg, and then keep her shoulders up, and then think about canter. Anywhere at all it can happen. Yes, yes, up, up, up. Yes!
Woohoo!
Keep her head up, yes!
Oh, yeah. Oops. Ooh. Oops, well, steady on, Bess.
So, if we get another good, we're going...
At this point, my instructor got on, just in case that these were naughty books, and they definitely weren't. Oh, sorry, that's the dogs. She was booking again when we asked her to canter right, and she was definitely saying, ouch. She was telling us that something was definitely wrong, so we just spent the rest of the lesson doing troll work and general schooling. So the booking had come back. She basically responded to the new way of working quite badly. So the day before was when I filmed my clipping vlog. If you haven't seen that, go check it out, give it a thumbs up. If you have a good memory, you will know that she books in that. Although we just thought that she was feeling fresh as she had just been clipped 20 minutes before that. But looking back at the videos, she may have been showing a book of pain. So we tried to school a little bit more and keep her in work until the physio could come out to treat her. So the physio did a great job and allowed Bess to feel a bit more free in herself. The physio said that if Bess isn't starting to show an improvement, then we may have to take her to the vet to do a gait analysis and see if there are any underlying problems or conditions. And of course, she continued booking. After the physio came and gave us the all okay, we went to various different things and outings. And one of these outings was arena hire with Lottie. And Bess wasn't feeling very comfortable. It was a horrible day as well, so I actually ended up getting on Archie. So here are a few clips from that. So after the physio, we did various things with her, including two pony club rallies, an arena hire with Lottie, and having some fun and games and going on a hack with Lottie. So after the arena hire, we decided to call it quits and just chill out for a bit. So after all those pizzazz and travelling backwards, we decided to give her a break from any major work and just hack and occasionally school. And we're talking about once every 2 to 3 weeks tops at the moment. So me and my mum have just been sharing rides between us, keeping it nice and chilled, and going on really long hacks to keep the pony busy. So when the weather starts to improve a little bit more, we're talking maybe late February to early March, we will start to school her a bit more and bring her back into a bit more of intense work, and see if that has an impact on anything, as we already know she behaves 10 times better in the summer. So a message to summer. Please come early. I want my insanely awesome pony back. So that's the plan for now. If anything changes, I shall let you guys know. Also, I have plenty of footage from Bess from when Bess was in action, so don't worry about video content. So anyway, I thought this would be a really good video to put up, as the current situation is very hard to explain. Also, I know this is a minor problem in terms of what we as a country are facing at the moment. I just want to say and explain it full, so I don't have to explain to anyone who asks. So let's all pray that my terrific pony will be back in action by the summer. He's far too young not to recover from any of this, so we'll just have to face the consequences no matter how large the trek. It would be such a waste of a pony for her not to recover, and she has so much potential, scope, power and ability, and she really does enjoy every second of her work. Thank you to everyone who has sat through this. I'm really sorry if this brought more of a bummer to your day with it being locked down in the UK and all. But then again, I have entertained you for however long this video ended up being. And there's no limit to how many times you can watch this video or any of my other videos, by the way. So I hope each and every one of you stay safe and that we can have a hell of a 2021. I'm going to end this video here, so please like and subscribe. I really do appreciate it, and I'll see you all next time. Bye. I can't keep calm, just every time I run, I keep on falling. I know what you told me. I know it's all over. I know I can't keep calm, just every time I run.